Krissy, I love that you're back in Maine.
Yo, what up, though? Calling for Krissy T.
Oh, it's Krissy.
What's she going to say next?
Krissy T in the morning, more like Krissy Unfiltered in the morning.
Maine's new way to wake up. Krissy in the morning on Portland's number one hit music station, Q97.9.
Yes, Krissy, you're on the queue. Let's go. Woo!
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
That's your cue. No pun intended. It's almost like you want a fist bump, but it's like too early in the morning and it's only Thursday. It is Thursday. Tomorrow is March 1st. Wow. The wind is just winding out there. My car was going back and forth. I drive a Jeep Wrangler. Does anyone else drive a Jeep Wrangler who knows what it's like to get on the highway when it's extremely windy? You have this tank of a car, right? They used them in the Army. They still do. And you still kind of fear that you're gonna flip over a little bit. Like they're made out of tinfoil, even though they're not. That was me this morning. Oh my God, I'm gonna lose my trucker hat. On my way into work, might even lose my whole car on the way in. Hey, Tom Segura is tonight in the Cross Insurance Arena. If anyone's going to that, let me know. I'm going to be there. I'm very excited about it. We got some tickets a long time ago, so my friends and I are going to go. 775-7979. That is the phone number if you want to call me. I want to hear who's awake right now. And who's battling the wind? What's the wind like? Let's do a wind.
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
I have a plane story for you. When do I not have an airplane story for you? A little insight about me. I'm probably gone most weekends. Well, I'm going to try to change that. I'm going to try to stay put for a minute. It's just the wintertime gets to me. Does anyone else have seasonal depression to a point where you just have to hop a plane? Doesn't matter where you go. You just got to go for the long weekend. Anyways, so I just got into watching 50 Shades of Grey. And yes, I know I'm late to the game. I've read the books. And they're hot and heavy. They're great. They're fantastic. And so I ended up watching it for the first time 2 days ago. And it was on the airplane. Now, here's the thing. I'm sitting in the middle. I had the middle seat, the good old middle seat. And I am so far into this movie that I'm not even looking up. I'm barely even breathing. I'm watching the whole thing. It with such detail. It's such a great movie. I then move into 50 Shades Darker, which if you are a 50 Shader, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But then I started feeling like the people to the left and the right of me were going to think that I was watching adult videos. Because the more the movie went on, the more it looked like an adult video. And I could see both of the ladies on either side of me just side-eyeing me. Like, what is this girl really doing this on the plane? So I felt I had a disclaim. I took my headphones out. I go, I'm sorry if this bothers you, but I am watching 50 Shades of Grey. It's not what you think. And one of them scoffed at me and the other one was like, oh, I love that movie. So she was side-eyeing me because she wanted to watch the adult movie.
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9. Say, dance for me, dance. Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Hello. You're done.
All right, here's what's going on. One of my best friends, who I shall not say her name, and I only have like two best friends, so I'm sure you know exactly who I'm talking to or talking about. Work wives and work husbands. I love this topic. It's a sticky topic. And if you watch Grey's Anatomy, you'll never trust your man again if he works in healthcare. Hers does happen to work in healthcare. Now, here's the thing. Lately, he's been texting a certain woman, the same person, almost every single night, a lot, after they get out of work. And he's just telling her, yeah, she's one of my best friends at work. And my friend keeps asking him, okay, well, can I see the text messages? And he's like, no, she's just a work wife. She's one of my work wives. He won't let her read the text messages. He will not let her read the text messages. And she's like, okay, if it's not that big of a deal, why don't you just show me? And he's like, I don't want you to think the way that we talk to each other is serious. So what that says to me is they're probably flirting. There's probably a little something there. And that is why people should not have work wives or work husbands. I hate that term. I do hate that term. I think it's so awkward. It is so awkward. And you know what, Maine? I want to know, how do you feel about this? And more recently, my friend says that he's been coming home later and later from work. He doesn't usually stay that late. And I'm assuming it's because his work wife is there. I don't want to put words in anybody's mouth. But this is why I don't think you should have a work wife. Because what if it translates into, if you like that person, then maybe go after them. But my question here is it okay to have a work wife or a work husband platonically? Or even in your own relationship? Man, I want to know, do any of you have a work wife? Do any of you listening right now have a work husband? Because to me, that's kind of a form of cheating. In a way, it's kind of a form of cheating. 775-7979. I'll tell you right now. If my man ever was like, I have a work wife. Don't worry about it. Yeah, well, you also don't have a girlfriend either. I'd be out. I'm too crazy for that. We all have Netflix. We all have HBO. We all know how these things go. Once you have a work husband and a work wife, it's over for your relationship. I said it. Once there is a work husband involved, your relationship is over. I'm sorry, but I'll say it. Q97.9, you are live on Krissy in the Morning. No swearing. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm actually now engaged to my work husband.
See? Do you see? You? Thank you. You just confirmed what I just said.
Yeah. Yeah, no. But he still has a work husband.
Wait. Hold on, your husband got a husband?
Not really, no, but they're best friends, and I call him his work husband.
Okay, that's okay. Now, let me ask you this. When you met your work husband, did you have a relationship? Were you in a relationship at the time?
I was, but he was cheating on me, and he gave me more attention at work.
Oh,
and
God.
Now we've been together for 2.5 years, and we just got engaged on Christmas.
Oh, well, number one, congratulations.
Thank you.
Number two, that was a lot for me to process.
I'm originally from Massachusetts.
Oh, that tracks.
I got a job. Then I moved up here for a guy. Found out he was cheating on me.
Ugh, scum.
Mm-hmm. Left him. And I got a lot of attention from my work husband. And now he's going to be my real husband.
And you know what? I love that story. See, that's a good story. Because I was hoping that it wasn't a story about, you know, you were in a relationship and you had a work husband. And then you left him and you got the work husband. So this is a good story. Good for you.
Thank you.
Good for you. What's his name? Shout him out. Ooh.
Johnny.
Oh. I don't have good experiences with those names. I'm going to go before I say something bad. Congratulations on your relationship. Q97.9. Hello. Oh, my God. What's happening? Hello?
Hello?
I'm going to make the executive decision and hang up on that one. I got to hit commercials. Keep these phone lines coming and these opinions coming. 775-7979. Work husbands, work wives, are they okay? What are your experiences with them? And chances are, and you know what? I'm just going to say it again because I like to say bold things. If you have a work husband and you're in a relationship, you're probably not getting what you need out of that relationship.
Krissy in the Morning on Q97.9.
The internet is a crazy place. We all know this, but Beyonce going country, big news. Post Malone trying to go country, also big news. And it's even weird saying Beyonce's new country song. It's wild to say that she's country now, but her new country song, Texas Hold'em, which I actually happen to really love, and it very much grew on me. And we play it right here on Q97.9. But it made the Billboard charts, and it is now number one, which is amazing. And congratulations to a queen. But of course, the internet is now trying to rip her down about it. the internet will do anything to be a damn troll. And what they're saying now is that Beyonce is ripping off the children's show, Franklin. Do you remember that? I remember the Franklin show, like, very barely, but I do remember it. Now, I have the intros to both Texas Hold'em, Beyonce song, number one on the Billboard charts, and also the intro to Franklin. It took me a little bit to find it, but I found it. Because if the internet wants to be out here telling me that Beyonce is ripping off a children's show from years and years and years ago, do you think she cares? Do you think she was watching Franklin? Is that what it was? She's watching Franklin and she just decided to write a song about it? I mean, that's crazy. This is crazy. But people are actually, they're almost turning on her. It's no longer Queen Bee. It's Queen Franklin after all the comments I'm reading. This is ridiculous. But listen to this. And you tell me if Texas Hold'em sounds like Beyonce is ripping off the children's show, Franklin. I put them both back to back.
This ain't Texas. Hey, it's Franklin. Hey, it's Franklin.
You can tell the difference, right? Let me play it one more time. Beyonce. Queen Bee. Number one on the Billboard charts.
This ain't Texas.
Franklin, children's show.
Hey, it's Franklin.
You know what it is? I think it's just this compared to this. It's totally different. It's totally, totally ready. And I'm just realizing this live on air. No way, in any way, shape, or form the same. It's just what? They both used a banjo. It's not illegal to use a banjo. One more time.
This ain't Texas.
Go ahead, Franklin.
Hey, it's Franklin.
Not even close. Not even close. I'm sorry, but don't come after Queen Bee like that. She doesn't need to go after a children's theme song for success. She's already successful. At this point, she's just doing music because she loves it. Because she loves it. Does not sound like...
Hey, it's Franklin.
I don't know. What do you think? What do you think? I'll just leave my phone lines open. 775-7979. We can debate.
Well, good morning, Krissy.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Noise.
Noise who?
Nice to see you. How are you?
Nice to see you.
Q97.9.
Tom Segura, a lot of people's favorite comedian, is here in Portland. He's doing a show, gearing up for his show tonight at the Cross Insurance Arena at 7:30. Tom, welcome back to Krissy in the Morning. One of my friends told me that I had to ask you this. You've got some kids, and he had heard in a podcast that you had done that they call you Tom instead of Dad, and that you have some pretty colorful kids.
My youngest is stealing my money. That's another thing.
Cool. Tell me about that.
I'm just like, I always have money, like a little bit of money in a money clip.
Yeah.
It's never...
Is that for show?
Like, what's that?
Is that for show? Or is that, I always wonder, like, dudes that carry around hundreds in their money clip where you could see, like, one
no,
side of the hundred?
It's just, like, it's easy access because the clip goes in your front pocket. Like, a wallet for me is, like, identification and some credit cards.
Yeah.
But I just keep the cash in this little thing just so you have cash. And I never have, like, a crazy amount of money in it, but it always has something. You know what I mean? It's never empty.
Yeah.
So... I throw it on the nightstand, and I walk by it the other day, and it's empty, which, like, I just go, like, it almost took me a second. I was like, is that my money clip? And then I go, like, well, there's no money in it. Like, and I have to process it. And then I walk up to my little dude, and I was like, hey, man, did you take money from my nightstand? And he's like, no. And I go, for sure you didn't? And he goes, no. And I go, if I promise you're not in trouble, I promise. I just need you to tell me the truth. did you take my money? And he goes, yeah, I took it. And I go, okay. He goes, do you want to see it? And I go, sure. So he takes me to his bedroom, and in his closet, he has 3 Ziploc bags with cash in them.
Oh, my God. Go, is he drug dealing? Has he figured out how to drug deal?
He's 5.
Oh, sorry. Okay, sorry. You're right. Keep going.
I go, yeah. I mean, I don't know what he's doing. He might be drug dealing. I'm like, I go, okay. He goes, I don't know what was yours, so I can't really give it back, but it's in one of these bags. I'm like, okay, dude. I go, you can't steal money. He's like, okay. He goes, can I have money? Like, will you give me some? And I go, no. And he's like, okay, well, no promises. And I go, okay. So now I have a kid that calls me Tom and a kid that robs me.
Okay. I respect the hell out of that. It could be worse.
Well, yeah, it could be.
It could be worse. But you know what? You're raising a little hustler. I like that.
I actually like that too. I like that they're not super passive.
Yeah, like he's monetizing what he wants to monetize, and your other one that called you Tom, I mean, he's just doing what he wants to do. He's, you know, I kind of admire your kids.
The kind of cool thing about kids is, like, you get to see people before they're, like, kind of infected with being self-conscious, with, you know what I mean? Like, they...
Yeah, traumas and manners.
Grow up, yeah, like, they grow up. They have, like, a good environment. They're, like, naturally confident. They think highly of themselves.
Yeah, man, and that's nothing, a great
you're
point.
You're like, oh, man, you just want to keep that going. So, yeah, dude, like, keep stealing. Keep doing that.
See, that's good parenting, you know? Others might say it's bad to steal. But when you really break it down, keep stealing, dude. That makes you who you are. You're never going to be self-conscious because you know what you're doing.
You're never gonna like need for something. That's very good. Keep doing that.
Yeah, I really like that parenting style. That's fantastic. Now,
thank you.
Kids are so funny, right? Because they're always so honest. And I don't have kids. I'm 30 years old and completely single. But what I do notice is kids love to just tell the God honest truth. And you know, if something in front of them is ugly or bothering them, they'll just be like, "Hey, dude, like you're ugly, man." And it's like it's the full truth.
They are brutally honest. Wait, if you really want to be brought down a peg,
wait till one of
your kids sees you naked. Like they walk in and you're changing clothes and then they just start laughing and you're like, okay. And then they're like, you have a fat butt. And you're like, okay, thank you. And they just like start pointing at you and you're like, please leave the room.
Yeah.
Cover up, please. They tell you the truth about everything.
Oh, it's so funny. Okay, why don't we do this while we have Tom Segura on the phone? 775-7979 for those of you with kids and want to go to his show tonight at the Cross Insurance Arena. I've got some tickets for you exclusively here on Krissy in the Morning. All you have to do is call me right now and let me know. What has your kid done to embarrass you? Has your kid stolen anything from you? What do your kids call you? Anything that Tom Segura just said about his children. Can you relate? I got to know. We're going to hit commercials. I'm going to talk to a bunch of you, and we'll be right back.
Portland's number one hit music station, Q97.WJBQ, Portland, a town square. Krissy in the Morning on Q97.9.
Tom Segura, one of my favorite comedians, one of your favorite comedians. He was just on the show, and thank you, Tom, if you're on your way back to your hotel room for coming back in again this morning to tell us about your embarrassing children's stories. But everyone's got one is what we're figuring out here. Everyone's got one. Kids are going to be kids. And if you want to go to the show tonight at 7:30, go see a comedy show on me and on Tom because he gave me one more pair of tickets to give out today to you. It's one lucky winner who has the best story of what their kids do to them in public. Call me right now. Phone lines are open. 775-7979. Gonna take them live. Hello. Welcome to Krissy in the Morning.
Hello, Krissy. Good morning.
Good morning, babe. Who's this?
This is Ash.
All right, Ash, where are you from?
New Gloucester.
All right, tell me about your kids.
Well, I have 4 of them.
Oh, God.
Yep. My youngest is 10. He's my everything.
Cute.
And lately, he's been utilizing the credit card at the self-checkout and being very assertive as a would-be employee, but being 10 years old, Huh. I tell him to slow down, but he just insists on being the self-checkout employee.
Okay.
And he grabs candy bars at the end.
Okay, so walk me through this. He's working, like he's pretending like he's working the self-checkout line?
Yes.
Okay, so he's stepping in for the employees at the grocery store and bagging people's groceries for them.
Bag our belongings. He would bag others if he could.
Oh my God, that's amazing. And then he just takes candy bars at the end as like, you got to pay him for it.
Yeah. That's the part that I just, you know, I wish there was a bag of like apples or maybe a bunch of bananas.
So he's like, I'm going to do this work that you didn't ask me to do, and then you're going to pay me for it.
Oh, yes.
A hustler.
That goes back to the 25-year-old that I have that I realize is a common theme.
A hustler. Yeah, wait till you have girls that have sugar daddies. Ha
ha. I'm looking for one.
I gave that life up in Detroit. I'm not allowed to talk about it here in Maine.
What stays in Detroit? Stays in Detroit, that's for sure.
I think it's what happens in Detroit stays in Detroit, but you got the right mindset.
Yeah.
I'm going to put you in the running, girl, for these Tom Segura tickets, okay?
All right, thank you, hon.
You naughty little biscotti.
Why don't you just meet me in the middle? Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
I got these Tom Segura tickets. And the way you get yourself in the door tonight to a 7:30 comedy show at the Cross Insurance Arena is you call me right now and you try to beat the last person's story about what their kid did to them in public. That was embarrassing. Embarrassing kid stories. We're going after it. Q97.9, you are live. Please don't swear. Do I have your promise?
I promise. I won't swear.
Okay, thank you, girlfriend. What's your name, babe? I feel like I know you.
Yeah, Christine.
Okay, Christine.
I met you at Merry Madness, actually.
Oh, my God. Isn't that funny how I genuinely was like, okay, I feel like I know you right now?
Yeah.
That's awesome. What were you wearing? Because I remember everyone from Merry Madness.
Oh my gosh. I was with Matthias Savings. I was wearing an orange Santa hat. I don't know. Nothing too crazy.
Yeah,
nothing like you were wearing.
What was I wearing?
Oh my gosh, you were wearing like that Santa onesie.
Oh yes, my Santa onesie.
Yes.
Oh my God, I had like the little cotton balls on it. Like, who did I think I was that day?
Oh, it was amazing. It was amazing.
Girlfriend, I totally remember you. You were working it, right?
I was.
Yes. Oh, you were so much fun. Okay, so now I know you've got a story. Go ahead, girl.
Oh, I do. So my daughter is 3, and she calls her lady bits, her little bum.
So her little bum?
Target one day, and I had to bring her in the bathroom with me, and it was my time of the month. And she was really alarmed that, you know, mama was bleeding. So
it's scary when you don't know what's up. It's scary when you don't know what it is.
Oh my gosh, I know. But then, so that was the end of that. I thought it was over. And then we start shopping and she's telling everyone that I'm bleeding. My little bum is bleeding and that mama's hurt. I was like, oh my God. Oh my God.
She's like, call 911. Call 911. My mom just got attacked.
Luckily, like nobody really knew what she was talking about, but it was still just so embarrassing.
Oh my God. So you say little bum or is it little bun like with an N?
It's little bum.
Okay. Well, guess what? You and your little bum are going to go to Tom Segura tonight, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Oh God, that's so good. That's really good. Now, have you ever had a talk with her about what little bum might actually mean?
Not yet, but that's definitely coming soon.
Okay, we haven't gotten there yet, but it's in the future, okay?
Yeah, I don't know. I think little bum is so cute. I don't want to correct it, but I need to. I know I need to.
No, you know what? No, you don't need to. No, you don't, because you know what I call it?
What?
I call it a Pikachu.
There you go.
I call it a Pikachu, and every man I ever date, they have to say that. Hello, how's your Pikachu?
I love that.
You know? All right, girly, I'm going to put you on hold. Don't go anywhere. We're going to hit commercials. Congratulations.
All right, thank you.
All I do is win, 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 no matter what.
Well, bum. Oh, baby. You naughty little biscotti. Why don't you just
meet me in the middle? Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Hi, how are you? What's your name? Tell me everything. Social Security, debit. I'm just kidding.
Good, how are you?
Good, who's this?
My name's Jake.
Jake, tell me what your kids do to embarrass you or anything that Tom Segura just said.
The most recent one I can remember is into Target with my wife, and I have a 6-year-old son and a 4-year-old daughter.
Yeah.
And we're walking past the bra section, and my daughter says, Daddy, do you need one of those?
Oh, no. Nothing like your kid telling you passively aggressively that you got to go to the gym.
Yeah, got those man boobs going on, you know?
Oh, man, you should have bought one. You should have bought one.
I know, I should have. You're right. I'm missing out.
Oh, that is so funny. This is why I love kids. They don't care. If you're ugly, you're ugly. If you're fat, you're fat.
Right? Yeah, it doesn't matter. God's honest truth, you know?
Yeah, and you can't hate him for it, you know what I mean?
No, I was just like, okay, keep walking, let's go.
Now, what size bra do you think you would be, should you have had to buy one?
Oh, probably not too bad, maybe a B, though.
All right, so you're probably like a 36B, maybe?
Small B, large A.
I don't think it works like that. I think it's small A, large B.
Oh, yeah. There we go.
Daddy needs to go back to school, too.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, it's been a while since I, tried one on.
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
I didn't realize how much I was going to love hearing your embarrassing kid stories in public until now. What a show. This is fantastic. Hello, good morning.
Hello, Krissy. Good morning.
Good morning, babe. Who's this?
This is Ash.
All right, Ash, where are you from?
New Gloucester.
All right, tell me about your kids.
Well, I have 4 of them.
Oh, God.
Yep. My youngest is 10. He's my everything. And lately, he's been utilizing the credit card at the self-checkout and being very assertive as a would-be employee, but being 10 years old. I tell him to slow down, but he just insists on being the self-checkout employee.
Okay.
And he grabs candy bars at the end.
Okay, so walk me through this. He's working, like he's pretending like he's working the self-checkout line?
Yes.
Okay, so he's stepping in for the employees at the grocery store and bagging people's groceries for them.
Bag our belongings. He would bag others if he could.
Oh, my God, that's amazing. And then he just takes candy bars at the end as, like, you got to pay him for it.
Yeah. That's the part that I just, I wish there was a bag of, like, apples or maybe a bunch of bananas.
So he's like, I'm going to do this work that you didn't ask me to do, and then you're going to pay me for it.
Oh, yes.
A hustler.
That goes back to the 25-year-old that I have that I realize is a common theme.
A hustler, yeah. Wait till you have girls that have sugar daddies.
Ha ha. I'm looking for one.
I gave that life up in Detroit. I'm not allowed to talk about it here in Maine.
What stays in Detroit stays in Detroit, that's for sure.
I think it's what happens in Detroit stays in Detroit, but you got the right mindset.
Yeah.
I'm going to put you in the running, girl, for these Tom Segura tickets, okay?
All right. Thank you, hon.
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Oh, this one doesn't get old for me. So, as some of you know, I went back to New Jersey this past weekend to go visit my parents, my mom and my dad, and we're all super close. So it's a fun time. So my mom and I, we used to go people watch in her car while my dad was working and get out of school. And we had this one people watching perch, which actually ironically was Dunkin' Donuts. And it's really cool to be endorsed by Dunkin' Donuts, 15 years later, because we used to sit outside and just people watch. And so what I did was I was like, Mom, let's do what we did old school days. We sat outside Dunkin' Donuts and I had her hold my little mini microphone and say my show name. I'm like, isn't this funny? 15 years down the line, we're in front of Dunkin' Donuts and I made something out of myself. You know, I've got a radio show. How about I have you be a part of the radio show? I'll have you introduce my show. All you have to say is Krissy in the morning. And this is what I got. This is what I got.
Talking to the phone and saying, I'm Krissy T's mom and this is Krissy in the morning.
I'm Krissy T's mom and this is Krissy T in the morning.
No, Krissy in the morning.
Oh. Hi, I'm Krissy T's mom. Hi, I'm Krissy T's mom. Hi, I'm Krissy T's mom.
And this is Krissy in the morning. Okay. You don't even know my own show. Okay.
Hi, this is Krissy T's mom, and I'm watching Krissy in the morning. Tell me what to say.
Hi, I'm Krissy's mom, and this is Krissy in the morning.
Hi, I'm Krissy T's mom, and this is Krissy in the morning.
Boom. My mom's out here thinking I'm on the Disney Channel, like Miley Cyrus.
Hey, I'm Miley Cyrus from Hannah, Montana, and you're watching Disney Channel.
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
All right, I got to jump out of here. Spray tan Thursday in full effect. If you did not hear me earlier, Suntan City. That's where you got to go. Suntan City. Now, the one on Forest Ave in Portland, that's my favorite one. I always go there. The ladies there are fantastic. And if you have any questions about a membership and all of the other things that they offer besides just a spray tan, please DM me, Krissy T Radio. I will give you all the details, fill you right in. And just make sure that when you go in there, be like, hey, Krissy sent me. It'll take care of you. But I'm going to jump out of here. Have so much fun. If you have won Tom Segura tickets from Krissy in the morning this week. And I'll see you tomorrow for Fire Flame Friday. And if you would like to get some Fire Flame Friday submissions in, some shout outs, please also DM me those. Or you can email me. Or even put them on our Q97.9 app. Feel free to text it. And have an awesome Thursday. And if it makes you happy, it can't be the